Hey, what's going on everyone? This is iReviews back with another video, and today I will show you guys how to enable 10 hidden features on your iPhone, of course using settings that are kinda secret on your iPhone. Now, using these features is not possible if you don't change these settings. These will make it available for you to use these features that are actually very, very useful. Now, another very useful thing is of course the like button of this video. That will help the channel a lot and of course will help this video do much, much better. So make sure you leave a like. First of all, I will show you guys how to enable a setting that allows you to open any app you want directly from the lock screen of your device. I mean, any app that you have on your device. Any one of them can be opened from the lock screen or quickly from anywhere on the device. You can see right here, you can double tap to go to the app store. I can tap and hold here to go to the phone app. Single tap to go to Instagram. You can choose up to 3 different apps. Now, of course, to do that, you will have to enable a setting and do something else. I will show you guys how to achieve that. So you basically go to your settings, you go to accessibility, and then you go to touch right here, go to assistive touch, make sure you enable it, and you will have the custom actions right here. So you can see I have here Instagram, App Store, and phone. If you go to one of them, you will have different actions that you can do, but you won't actually find any of your apps right here. What you need to do is go to the shortcuts app, and here's what you do. It's very, very simple. You tap the plus button right there, tap on add action, tap on scripting here, and choose open app. From here, tap on choose, just choose any app you want. Let's just choose Amazon. Tap the next button, add a name here. So let's just add okay there. Click done, and now you're good to go. When you go back to the settings, to assistive touch, you will find that app right here. Now you can use that, so here we have the single tap, let's change to Amazon. I can single tap right there and you can see it will open Amazon, which is really, really awesome. So open any app that you choose, up to 3 different apps from the lock screen or anywhere on your device. Next up, I will show you guys how to receive phone calls on your MacBook or your iPad. What you need to do is go to your settings and go to the cellular settings. Right here, we'll find a section that says calls on other devices. Now this will be off. You go here, you enable it, and it shows a list of all of your devices. So when I receive calls here, if I don't have my iPhone near me, I can receive those calls on my MacBook as well. Or if I want to, I can enable my iPad Pro or my other iPhones right here. So any call that comes from this phone can be actually redirected to one of those devices if I don't have my iPhone nearby. Very, very useful, especially if you use your Mac all the time. Like a lot of the time during the day, I'm on my Mac. So if I don't have my iPhone nearby, if it's charging or somewhere else, basically this will just send the calls to my MacBook. Next up, I will show you guys a pretty cool setting that you will find on the mail settings. So you can see right here, when you go to your emails, you will see a list like this. Now you see a preview of the email, you will see just the first 2 rows. You can actually change that by going to settings, go to email, and from here, what you need to do is go to preview, and you will have from none up to 5 lines. So from here, you can change to 5 lines. You can see you will get a much, much bigger preview here of the email. Or if you just don't want to see that at all, of course, then you can change to none. And this is how it will look. You will basically just see from who you got that email, and you won't actually see any of the content of the email at all. A pretty cool feature of iOS is of course the control center. It allows us to do a lot of things quicker. Now what you can do is of course add new buttons to the control center. And one of them which is really useful is the voice memo. Now if you add that, you can start recording a voice memo directly from the control center without having to actually use the app at all. So what you need to do is go to settings, go to control center, and find voice memo right here. It should be somewhere around the bottom here. And now when you're on your control center, you want to quickly start recording voice memo. You just 3D touch on this and tap on new recording. Right away, you're actually recording now a new voice memo, which is very, very cool. And of course, very useful if you just need to do that really quickly. Another really cool thing that you can do with voice memos is that if you go to the settings of voice memos within the settings app, lower here, we have voice memo. If you go here, you can find a setting that is called location-based naming. Now, if you enable this, and of course you have location services also enabled on your device, it will automatically name your voice recording based on the location you're on. So of course, when you go to your voice recordings, you will better know and much easier find recordings based on the location where they have been recorded. An amazing feature that Apple has added to iOS 13 was voice control. I really love that feature, and of course it can be enabled by going to accessibility. You will find voice control somewhere here it is, and you enable it right there. But of course this will stay on all the time, and it will consume battery in the background and might also have an impact on the performance of your device. But if you enable attention aware, then this will automatically switch it off when you don't have your attention to your iPhone. Whenever you have your attention to your iPhone, you can see right there, it will turn it back on. So this will be an amazing feature. If you use voice control, make sure you enable this, and it will be much, much easier having access to your voice control with this automatic feature. Another very useful setting can be found under accessibility. This will enable a pretty cool feature. So you go here and you go to touch, and right here you will find lower here actually called audio routing. So if you go here, then you will have the option to actually make your calls go automatically on Bluetooth if you're using a Bluetooth headset or a speaker. So if you have your iPhone connected all the time or most of the day to your Bluetooth headset or to a speaker, then you can make the calls go automatically to those devices, so you don't have to change that manually after you have received the call. You can also enable auto answer calls. So if you enable this right here, your iPhone will actually automatically answer a call after the amount of time that you set right here. So you will have, of course, these buttons to set the seconds. After how many seconds that the phone has been ringing, it will automatically answer that call. If you use the Notes app of iOS, the default Notes app, which in my opinion is probably the best one you can use on your iPhone, you will have a pretty cool feature if you use like checklists. Those are of course very useful, but if you go here, you will have this option that lets you sort the checked items automatically. So whenever you have a checklist, once you have checked one of the items, it will just place it on the bottom and you will have your unchecked items at the top, which makes it that much easier finding the stuff that you haven't done already. And of course, everything being automatic, it will be much, much better. And for the last two features, we're moving on to the podcast settings. So if we go under podcast here, you will find here a few settings that are actually very useful. Now, one of them is right here, skip buttons. Now you have the skip buttons on your podcast app, and they're probably fixed at 15 seconds. You tap to go forward or backwards with 15 seconds. But did you know that you can actually change that? You can go from 10 up to 60 seconds. You can choose how many seconds you want. You don't have to use the 15 seconds that are there by default. And of course, having podcasts on your device, you know that when you have a lot of them, they take a lot of space, which of course will consume the storage of your iPhone, and your story will go out really, really quick if you download a lot of podcasts. But right here, we'll have a setting that will enable a very useful feature: remove played downloads. Any podcasts that you have played and you have, of course, listened to, they will be automatically removed from your device, that way saving a ton of battery. So that's pretty much it for this video, guys. These are 10 amazing iPhone features that you can enable using these secret settings that you can find on your iPhone. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Go ahead and leave a like for more, and subscribe, of course, and I'll see you on the next one.